Ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to our next bout of the evening. This is an elimination MMA bout scheduled for three-minute rounds in the flyweight division. This bout is in honor of Sergeant Nicole G. Out of the red corner, Michelle Winick.
...125-pound female MMA action up for us next fight, fans. Michelle Winick has just been announced, and she's making her way down the entrance ramp. She's a representative of Trials MMA, making her debut this evening, and listen to the crowd go for her. By far the most uproarious applause we've had this evening. What a great feeling that's got to be. Some Vaseline on the brow, the bridge of the nose, and the eyebrows. Keeps the leather of the gloves from grabbing the skin and tearing.
Out of the blue corner, Kimberly Morales.
Is Kimberly Morales making her way down the entrance ramp? She's a representative of V10 training. She comes to us with the experience advantage, but a 0-2 record. So been in there a couple of times, but hoping to go home with her first win this evening.
Kimberly is a very aggressive fighter. She's not going to back down. When it comes to striking, she just goes for it.
That's what we like to see. Tail of the tape shows us Michelle Winick coming to us, 33 years of age, a little taller at 5'5", and her style is mixed. Also, Kimberly Morales lists her style as mixed martial arts. She's the younger at 20 years old, shorter of the two at 5'1" tall, and she has the experience advantage having been in the cage twice before. No matter what you do in the gym, you can never simulate what it feels like to get in the cage or the ring the first time for your real fight. Just first fight jitters can be a real thing that some people brush it off well.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, tonight's fights are in honor of the Navy SEALs Fund. Raffle tickets are available right up there on the fourth level at the Blue Bar and Grill. Proceeds of all of the tickets go to the Navy SEALs Fund. This is an elimination MMA bout scheduled for three-minute rounds in the flyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the leather neck, heating and cooling red corner. A mixed martial artist standing 5'5" tall. She weighed in at 128.8 pounds with Trials MMA, from Fort Collins, Colorado, Michelle Mayhem Winick!
A lot of Winick fans in the house.
Fighting out of the Estrella Jalico blue corner. She is the daughter of a U.S. Marine veteran. A mixed martial artist standing 5'1" tall. She weighed in at 135 pounds with V10 training out of Aurora, Colorado. Kimberly Bell of the Brawl Morales.
All right, Bell of the Brawl, possibly the best fighter nickname ever.
Ladies, you've had your final instructions. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Touch them up. Back to your corners, please.
Here we go. Women's MMA action. Flyweight division. Winick wearing the red tape. Morales the blue. Good exchange of strikes. Both fighters landing with solid effect. Nice cross by Morales. Winick took it well. Good mix of techniques from both these fighters. They're both using punches and kicks very well.
Winick needs to get her head off that center line.
Morales with a nice flurry there, partially because of her not getting off that center line like you alluded to. Fast pace early on by these two. She's marching forward with her strikes is Morales.
Morales is landing all of those clean. I don't know how many more Winick could take. It's going to build up on her.
Yeah, it sure is. Winick starting to breathe through her mouth. Her mouth's partly open. You're taking a lot of headshots. Fighting with your mouth open is not what you want to do. Ooh, hard clash of shins there. I was going to say, let's see if Morales goes to her knee striking game, and she does. Another hard clash of shins. That'll take an ice pack in the morning. And Morales just going to work, rights and lefts, rights and lefts. Winick answers back with a knee up the middle. And now with knees of her own is Morales. Morales really starting to pull ahead here.
She wants to finish this.
Good job with flurrying with her techniques. Not relying on a single strike. When she goes to unleash, she lets it happen with combinations. Nice job. And Morales just doing whatever she can to find a target. Hammering the insides of the thighs with punches. Only 10 seconds left. Gonna be hard for Winick to affect much work here off of her back. Did a good job initiating the takedown, but just not enough time left in the round. And Morales, good show of sportsmanship, helps up her opponent and makes her way back to her corner. Boy, you talked about the striking prowess of Morales. She put it on display here, and we see this replay here early in the fight. A little more even on the exchanges then, but as the round wore on, Morales beginning to really pull ahead and make it a bit of a one-sided affair.
I really like the way she was setting up her kick too. Just throwing those punches right in front of and then ending it with a kick. Throwing a clean combination and ending it with a kick or a knee.
As Boss Rutan would say, no naked kicks. Always set it up with your hands. Exactly what Morales was doing and the solid effect. So let's see if Winick decides to try to get it down to the ground earlier in the round where she has some time to work her jiu-jitsu game. Man, they have clacked chins hard a number of times.
That adrenaline's pumping, though.
Good point. Solid point. See if Winick tries to turn this into a takedown off the cage. Doesn't appear that Morales is trying to put it on the ground. Just working to pin her opponent against the cage and continue working that striking attack.
Nice.
Now Morales, yeah, now Morales gets her takedown. Winick opens the guard, showing she's going to try to start using her mobility a little bit here. It's going to be tough because she's up so close against the cage. Corner Winick calling for an up kick, and that's because Morales had her knees off the ground. Winick off of her back as she has the closed guard. Shows that she's not going to try for submissions or sweeps, and going for the can opener here is Morales. And the easy way to defeat the can opener is to open your guard and straighten your legs. The problem with that is it allows your opponent a chance to pass. So the can opener is either a submission or a utilization for passing.
If Morales can get past that guard, it's going to be bad news for Winick.
Agreed. Definitely would be able to be more effective with the striking. Speaking of effective striking, good series of hammer fists there for Morales. 45 seconds left. Morales doesn't even seem to be thinking about passing the guard. It's been open for quite a while now, and she's not trying to push a knee down or anything. Solid body punches from Morales.
Those are landing clean.
I was going to say, we're across the cage on the other side, and we can hear those shots going thump, thump, thump.
And
that's it. Referee has seen enough. It's the ground and pound of Morales. Changes the zero on the front of her record. Goes home with her first victory out of three times in the cage. So congratulations. Earning that first victory, working the solid ground and pound game. Morales really been putting in the work in the gym. You can tell for those fight fans that have watched her previous fights, she was just up a level this time. Checking it out here on the replay. This is when the corner of Winick was calling for the up kick, not able to get it in.
And that's another win for the Marines. Another TKO win.
And working that can opener now, trying to get that guard open. All right, we'll take it up to Stewie. He'll give us the official time of the stoppage. It was right at the end of the round.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Oscar Martinez called a stop to this bout. 2 minutes, 51 seconds into the second round, declaring your winner by TKO, Kimberly Bell of the Brawl, Morales!
The Bell of the Brawl got the tiara going for her first victory. Congratulations. Good sportsmanship there by both fighters.